Apparently, using a username and password is so, last year. A passwordless future is on the horizon, or at least trying to be. So let's talk about it. What are passkeys, and are they truly as secure as they claim to be? Passkeys are an authentication method that started gaining traction back in June of 2022. They were introduced as Apple Passkeys, but the technology already existed beforehand. It was known before as FIDO 2, developed by FIDO, an alliance of many top-level companies, all with the goal of reducing the world's reliance on passwords. So basically, Apple wrapped it all up in a neat package, made it user-friendly, and, well, gave it a name that stuck. Now that the superhero origin story is out of the way, what are passkeys and how do they work? Well, a passkey lets you sign into a service by using something you already have, like your phone and a fingerprint. Passkeys use two keys. One is a public key, and it's registered with whatever website or app you're trying to access. The other is a private key stored securely on your device. But that doesn't explain much of how passkeys work. So think of it this way. The public key is kind of like a doorbell. It doesn't store any of your sensitive info, so it can't open the door itself, but it allows the website to knock on the door and ask your device, "Hey, can you confirm who this is?" Your device has the private key and requests you to verify your identity, whether it's biometrics or a PIN. Then it can reassure the website, "Yeah, this one's legit." Unlike with traditional passwords, this whole process happens without your login info ever being stored or shared with the website. This way, if the website's data ever gets leaked, threat actors won't have access to your login info, which is why the answer to the "are passkeys secure" question is a yes. So it's easy to understand why passkeys are getting so hyped, and I'd say a good chunk of the popularity came from the fact that they became one of the top features in password managers. I mean, if passwords are gonna disappear, they gotta stay relevant somehow, right? Anyway, I myself only began trying passkeys out when NordPass introduced them into their app. If you don't have a password manager yet, this one is a great place to start, both for storing your general logins and creating passkeys, especially since you can get NordPass for cheap with a special discount deal linked in the description down below. But how do passkeys work on this app? Well, once you have your account logins in NordPass, check out the NordPass Passkeys tab on the left. I really like that NordPass automatically tells me which of my logins can be transitioned to passkeys, and then I can access those websites straight from here. The process of how to set up passkeys will differ on each site, but it's usually not complicated at all. For example, Passkeys Amazon setup with NordPass took like 1 second for me because the browser extension of the password manager simply asked me if I wanted a passkey. I said yes, and that was that. If this doesn't happen to you, you can just open the Amazon account, choose the login and security page, click the edit button near the passkey section, and then press to add a passkey. Easy peasy. Yet once you start using a passkey or two, you might notice a couple of downsides to this innovation. I mean, nobody's perfect. And for now, it looks like passkeys aren't fully replacing the whole username password combo like they've promised. They're only replacing the passwords themselves. So while most What Are Passkeys review promise that this feature's gonna make your login so much faster, in my experience, that's not really the case. If you've got a proper password manager with autofill, it takes about the same amount of time. To me, the biggest bummer is the fact that not all websites support passkeys. You can actually visit passkeys.io and check which sites allow this feature. But, well, the list is like a VIP exclusive for now. What's more, a passkey is heavily dependent on the device you store it on, so if you lose it or it gets stolen, you might have a bit of a hard time trying to regain access to your accounts. Now, if you store your passkeys in a password manager, it might make things a bit easier. This way you can access your account from wherever as long as you know your master password. Oh, and NordPass specifically allows you to share passkeys with trusted contacts. So if you have a family account and one of you loses access, the other will be able to help out. That's why I suggest trying out NordPass, especially since it's one of the cheapest password managers on the market, yet it increases the security of your accounts tenfold. Not to mention that it's a safe place to manage your passkeys and use them for quick and easy logins. Anyways, that's Passkeys Explained. Let me know if you already use a passkey somewhere and how your experience is going with that so far. I'll meet you in the comments.